In this video, we will look at an example of why, when we're asked to round, we should use exact values to perform calculations and then round at the very end. If we round too early, our answer will have much more of an error. Let's look at our example. An add-on line states that a 12-foot by 24-foot patio would cost $1,850 to be professionally installed. If the installation rate is based upon square feet or area, what would you predict the cost of a 20-foot by 35-foot patio to be? And we're told to round to the nearest dollar. Because the cost is based upon the square feet or area, let's begin by determining the area of the two patios. A 12-foot by 24-foot patio, which we will call A sub 1, is equal to 12 feet times 24 feet, which is equal to 288 square feet. And we know the cost of this patio would be $1,850. The second patio has dimensions 20 feet by 35 feet, and therefore the area, which we will call A sub 2, is equal to 20 feet times 35 feet, which is equal to 700 square feet, and the cost of this patio, C sub 2, is unknown. And now let's talk about the rate. The given rate is $1,850 per the area of the 12-foot by 24-foot patio, and therefore the rate can be expressed as $1,850 per 288 square feet. And we should use this exact rate to predict the cost of the second patio. But a common error is to find the unit rate, round, and then perform more calculations. To get the rounded rate of $6 per square foot, we would take $1,850 and divide by 288 square feet, which the nearest dollar does give us $6 per 1 square foot, or just $6 per square foot. And again, we don't want to do this, even though it does say a round to the nearest dollar, we don't want to round to the nearest dollar until the very end. And let's see why. To find the cost of the second patio, we begin with the area of the second patio and then multiply by the rate. The exact rate is $1,850 per 288 square feet. Using the exact rate, notice how the units of square feet simplify out, leaving us with a product of 700 times 1,850 divided by 288. And notice how the units are now dollars. And now let's go to the calculator. In the numerator, we have 700 times 1,850, close parenthesis, and then divided by 288. Now that we perform the calculation with the exact rate, we will now round to the nearest dollar. Because we have a 5 in the tenths place value, we round up to $4,497. Let's see how different the cost would be if we would have used the rounded rate of $6 per square foot. Once again, we begin with the area of 700 square feet and multiply by the rounded rate of $6 per 1 square foot. Again, the units of square feet simplify out, leaving us with dollars. But now using the rounded rate, notice how the product is 700 times 6 all over 1. And again, the units are dollars. This is just 700 times 6, which is $4,200. So notice how there's quite a big difference in the prediction if we use the exact rate compared to the rounded rate. So once again, we should use the exact rate and then round at the very end, which gives us an estimate of $4,497. And again, we don't want to use the estimate of $4,200 because this estimate has too much error. I hope you found this helpful.